लास्ट सेशन वी स्टार्टेड विद द टॉपिक स्कोप एंड इन दैट फर्स्ट स्कोप वी सॉ इजंट इट लोकल स्कोप एंड इन दैट लोकल स्कोप ओनली वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस राइट एंड मेनी डिस्कशंस वेंट देन संजय गेव वन एग्जाम्पल. संजय इज एब्सेंट टुडे आई गेस. गुड इवनिंग निश्चय.
तो
व्हाट हैपेंस आई टोल्ड यू इन द लास्ट सेशन इन दिस केस राइट नाउ इन दैट पुणे फंक्शन ओनली देर इज अ लोकल वेरिएबल डिक्लेयर्ड राइट. वन लोकल वेरिएबल इज क्रिएटेड तो दिस ए इट ट्राइज टू रेफर्स द लोकल वन ओनली बट व्हाट हैपेंस इज यू आर यूजिंग इट बिफोर इट्स असाइनमेंट देयरफॉर इट गिव्स अ एरर अनबाउंड लोकल एरर दैट इज अ लोकल वेरिएबल बट इट इज used before its declaration. Okay, so this error I hope you got it. This we had discussed last time. Then one more in local only I have to tell you that the parameters are also considered as local only. Whatever parameters you pass, they are also considered as local variables only. Okay, see, now this is the variable created outside function definition, isn't it? Good evening, Astik. अरे दरवाजा बंद करना. नाउ टू दिस फंक्शन आई एम पासिंग वन वेरिएबल ए. तो दो यू आर पासिंग द वेरिएबल विद द सेम नेम एज दैट ऑफ दिस ग्लोबल. द ग्लोबल वेरिएबल इज ए एंड द पैरामीटर विच यू आर पासिंग इट्स नेम इज ए. स्टिल दिस ए एंड दिस ए इज डिफरेंट. This A is global and this A is local. So that's what my intention to tell you, that whatever parameters you pass, they are also considered as local variables only. Their scope is also restricted to that function. Clear? Okay. So don't assume that this A means this global only. This global A is different and the parameter A is local. Like suppose you are inside adding to that a 20, a plus equal to 20. Now I'm printing a. See, first I'm printing a. That a which I'm printing is this one, because this print is outside the function definition. So this is the global a. It will print 10. Right? Now I'm calling that function to which I'm passing a. F of a, I'm calling the function f and to that I'm passing a. So the a which is passed is this global, but that value is collected in local. Okay, now that local a gets incremented by 10 and the local a becomes 20. Function over. Okay, and again if you try to print your a, it will be still 10. You understanding? Clear? Because this a which is incremented by 10 is not the global one, it is the local one. Okay, whatever parameter you pass, it is also local. So that local a is incremented by 10. When you called that function, so your global a is passed in this local a. The local a will have 10, but local a 10 plus 10 20, but that is local a only. Function over, come back. Now still when you access this a, it is still 10 only. Clear? So I hope it is clear. This concept is clear to you. This we had discussed last time. Okay? This explanation also I hope I told you. Right, no? In this case. So coming to this, note that the parameters are also considered as local variable. Whatever parameters you pass, they are local. Their scope is restricted to function. Example, a equal to 10. As this is on this terminal, which is outside function, so this is a global a. You have defined one function, Pune, with the parameter a. But the name of the parameter is a. But it is not same as this global a. This a is different and this a is different. That local a is incremented by 20 and it becomes 30. That local a increments by 20 and it becomes 30. But local a become 30, not this a. See here, before Pune call, I am printing a. Then I am calling Pune. And then again I am printing a. So when I print my global a, it is still 10. Clear? I hope it is clear to you. Right, all of you? So just give me that confirmation so that we can move ahead.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now coming to global scope. Actually,
yes,
global
sir, sir,
scope.
One question.
Huh.
So if I write f of 20, then what it will refer that 20 value, right?
Yes, yes.
Instead of 10.
Here, na, while calling. When you are calling it and directly you are passing 20. This way you want to say?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So when you are saying f of 20, so this constant value 20 is passed in this local a. 20 plus 10, 30, but still local a is 30. Correct? This
so
outer,
when I print a, it will print what? 10 or 20?
10 only.
10 only. 10 only. Okay.
Yeah. See ya. Still when I print a, it is 10 only. Because this
yes,
20
sir.
Which is copied is in local A, not in this outer A. Because global A and local A are different. Though the name are same, the scopes are different. Getting? In my
yes, sir,
this batch also, there can be a person with Nishchay. And in another batch also, there can be a person with name Nishchay. But though the name is same, the entities are different. So here also same thing. The name is same, but the scopes are different. This A scope is within the function. This scope A is global. Correct? Though the name is same. Okay. Now coming to global scope. Actually global, I'm taking a second, but it is actually third level. There is one scope between both of them. Clear? Called as a non-local scope or enclosing scope, which is between local and global. Local and global, there is an intermediate one called as non-local. So we'll discuss that too. First we'll talk about global. Okay? So global scope means all the variables which are created outside the function definition. Those variables which are created outside function definition, they are global. And their scope is throughout the script. Okay? Throughout the script. Meaning the inner functions also can access it. Inner name means functions also can access it. Like here you have created a. This a which is created, which is not within any function. This statement is nowhere within a function. It is outside the function. Therefore it is global. Now it is accessible throughout the script. Meaning it is accessible within the functions also. Okay? Those who have not created their own variable with the same name. Meaning inside this whole function body, if you are only accessing A, it will access this A. But suppose if you assign something to A, it will create its own. That is the rule. See, you are assigning this 20 to A. So the moment you assigned one value to A within the function body, it will create its own A. This A is now treated local. Okay, but if I don't do any assignment, you are only using it. Okay, so in this whole function body, if I am using this A, I am using a variable with the name A, like in print I am using A, so it will use this global one. But within the function body, if it encounters any definition for A, so it will create its own, that is local, and it will start using the local one. Clear? I hope you are understanding what I am trying to tell you. तो ग्लोबल स्कोप कंसेप्ट इज वेरी सिंपल, द वेरिएबल्स विच आर डिफाइंड आउटसाइड द फंक्शन मीन्स दे आर नॉट डिफाइंड विद इन द फंक्शन बॉडी. सी हियर ऑल्सो ए इज गेटिंग डिफाइंड, हियर ऑल्सो ए इज गेटिंग डिफाइंड, बट हियर ए इज डिफाइंड इन साइड फंक्शन बॉडी एंड हियर ए इज डिफाइंड आउटसाइड फंक्शन बॉडी. तो द वेरिएबल्स विच आर डिफाइंड आउटसाइड फंक्शन बॉडी दे आर ग्लोबल, दे आर एक्सेसिबल थ्रू आउट द स्क्रिप्ट. थ्रू आउट द स्क्रिप्ट मीन्स इंक्लूसिव द फंक्शन ऑल्सो, फंक्शन ऑल्सो कैन एक्सेस इट. बट इफ विद इन द फंक्शन बॉडी देर इज अ डेफिनेशन ऑफ सेम नेम वेरिएबल देन इट विल बी अ लोकल, इट विल स्टार्ट यूजिंग द लोकल वन. क्लियर? ओके. तो वेरिएबल्स डिफाइंड आउटसाइड फंक्शन इज कॉल्ड एज ग्लोबल. क्लियर? द एक्सेस इज वेयर थ्रू आउट द प्रोग्राम, इट्स स्कोप इज थ्रू आउट द प्रोग्राम. तो थ्रू आउट द प्रोग्राम मीन्स इज इट एक्सेबल थ्रू आउट द प्रोग्राम माइनस द फंक्शंस और ऑल्सो द फंक्शंस ऑल्सो एज वेल.
ऑल्सो द फंक्शन,
बट द क्राइटेरिया इज दोज फंक्शंस हैव नॉट डिफाइंड अ वेरिएबल विद द सेम नेम. क्लियर? तो इट इज having the scope throughout the script. So it is throughout the script except functions, or throughout the script except those functions which have defined their own. Clear? If there is another function g, another function h, so the script, this a scope is throughout the script minus those functions, those who have defined a variable of their own with the same name. If they have defined a variable of the same name of their own, then it is local. Now it won't refer this one. It will start referring its own. Getting? But if such definition is not there, you are just using it, so it will use the global one only. Getting? So its scope is throughout the program. Note that if we try to assign a value to a variable with the same name as the global variable name, then will it change the global variable or will it create a local variable of its own? What I said, if within the function you are trying to assign a value to a variable with the same name as the global name, then will it create its own local variable or it will modify the global one?
Own local variable.
Own local variable.
Clear? See here. Inside the function, then it will create a local variable. This is the scope rule. This is the scope rule of Python. Okay. Example C. If you want, I'll show you here. A equal to 10 we have as a global. Def A. Okay. If I'm printing A, def A, def F file, take some other function name. Print A. Okay. See here, you're printing A. 10. You called F and inside F also you are printing A. So you are just accessing. So will it access the global only?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Clear? And now if you try to print A, which is 10.
Local.
No, still global only. I am printing it outside. Global only printing. This function also prints global and this is also printing global only. Okay? Now see, A equal to 10, I am defining a function, inside that function I am writing A equal to 20, I am printing A. Okay, see here. Now before the call of function I am printing A, is it going to print that global A, which is 10?
Yes.
Correct? Then I am calling F, but when I call F, inside F there is a variable with the name A created, which is same as the global name. So will it store 20 in that global or will it create a variable A of its own?
Local.
Create a variable of its own.
Local variable. And it will print that local variable value, that is 20. Right? But now if you try to print your global A, is it modified to 20 or it is still 10 only?
10 only.
10 only.
10. Clear? But now you may have a question that I don't want to create a local variable with the name A, but rather it should modify the global one. Means The 20 should not get saved in a local. It should save in this global only. It should modify global. Then is there any provision? Yes, we have. By using a global keyword. So we are going to learn it. First, we'll cover up with this four types of scope and then we will be coming to that topic. Okay? See ya. What I've done is a equal to 10. I'm defining one function Pune in which I'm printing a, I'm creating own local variable b and printing b. Okay? Now when you call Pune, it comes to Pune function and it tries to print a, but it prints which a? You're just accessing. And is there any variable with the name a defined in this whole scope? Inside this whole function body, is there any variable with the name a defined? No. So it will take it from the global scope. Okay? It will take it from here, that is 10, create its own b, it will print that. So will it print 1020? Yes. Okay, so I hope you got it. So whenever you are creating a variable outside the function body, then it is treated as global. Its scope is throughout the function, inclusive the throughout the function, throughout the program, inclusive functions as well. Clear? Except which functions? Those who have defined a variable with the same name. You understanding? Those functions which have defined a variable of their own with the same name as the global name, then for them the global is not accessed. Clear? So that concept, I hope it is clear to you.
Sir, if we are importing one class into one module and that class, that module also having same name with global variable, then?
That module is containing variables.
Same name as a global variable name and importing class is also having
same. No, but
same.
Only one will get created. The other one will get replaced.
After importing,
yes. If you have, means inside that module, there is, you want to say inside that module, there is a variable with some name.
Yeah.
Right? I'll tell you. Like this is one module, and here you have created one variable, a equal to 10. And now this module in some other you have used it, correct? So
yes.
How you import it, on that it depends. Like if you have just written import and this module name X. So you have just written import X. So obviously this A you will access by X dot only. No? You are going to precede that A.
Yeah.
But if you have written from X import star, then you will use directly A.
Yes.
Correct. So now it won't allow you to create another A with the same name. This A only.
Oh, means
like,
that module can't have
now
that
if you
same name.
Say A equal to 20, it will store in this A only 20. Means this A only will become 20. Correct. And actually that doesn't come in the global scope. It goes in super global scope, which is accessible to all the scripts. No?
Okay.
The data which is accessed between all the script doesn't come in global also, it goes in super global scope.
That time A is having super
global. Clear? But if you are accessing it by that name X dot, because if you have just written import X, right, and now you want to access this A, so you will access it by writing X dot A. So you are qualifying it with that module name. So now you can create one separate A also of its own, which will be global.
That X dot A is limited to that module.
No, but it is accessible here.
Yes,
you have imported
can
this module. This is X file in which A dot A equal to 10 is created. This you have imported in this module. Getting? Import
yes.
X and you are accessing this A here by writing X dot A. And in this script also, you have created your own A. Correct?
Okay.
So now this A which you are accessing now from this script here, that is super global, and this A is global, which is throughout the script. Clear?
Yes.
But if you are not writing import x, you are writing from x import star. So that time it won't allow you to create a global one. It will say use this super global A only. It won't allow you to create a global A. You understanding?
Okay. Yes, yes.
Because that time you won't be preceding x dot, no? You'll be using directly A.
Directly.
When you write from x import star. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Coming to the third scope, that is enclosing. Now, actually, enclosing is between global and local. When a global scope and local scope, the intermediary one is the enclosing scope. Clear? So actually enclosing is the second concept, but unless and until global and local is clear, you won't know this thing. Now, what the peculiarity of enclosing scope? So this is concerned with nested functions, which is specially in scripting languages only, like C doesn't give, C, C++, Java and all. These languages don't allow you to give, allow you to define nested functions. Function within function. You cannot define one function inside another. Like this, define f. Okay? And then inside that, again I am defining one more function, that is g. This is the speciality of only scripting languages. Like in JavaScript you can do, PHP you can do, Python you can do. Correct? Nested definition. We are defining one function inside another. This thing is not possible in static type languages, strict type languages. Okay, like in C we can call one function inside another, but you cannot define one function inside another. Correct? So actually enclosing scope is applicable for nested definitions, when it defining one function inside another. Okay, now first remember the inner function which you have defined inside outer, the defined inner function, outer function, or you can call it as the enclosing function, enclosed function. F will be called as a enclosing, and who is enclosed? G. And G to G, who is enclosing? F. Therefore F is to be called as an enclosing function, and g is to be called as an enclosed function. And enclosing, enclosed becomes difficult for you. Use a very simple word, outer, inner. Clear? Now, first point, Python allows you to define one function inside another. Or you can define one inner function inside some outer function. Point one. Second, this inner function you cannot directly call outside outer. This G can be called only within this outer anywhere. Inside that outer definition, anywhere this G can be called. But outside outer, you cannot call this inner. Outside F, G cannot be called directly. There is another indirect provision, that is passing returning concept is there. I'll come to it. Okay. So indirectly you can return this G and then do it, but directly G cannot be accessed outside outer. Outside outer you cannot. You can access this G only inside inner, anywhere. Clear? Hear carefully. Then you'll say why we need it. So when you need some local work, you don't want to make it reusable, or you don't want to distribute to others. Like you need this function only for that particular local activity. Means within this code only, within this outer code, I need something which is only for that purpose. Later I don't need anywhere else, or I don't want to make it reusable anywhere else. When one time use, so we go for inner such functions. Okay. Now coming to the scope concept. Python says all the variables of outer, including parameters also. If there are parameters, like here, if there is a parameter x and y, and it has created its own variable z also. Clear? So all the variables of outer are accessible to inner. Same concept like global, correct? But here outer inner mechanism. Okay, so all the variables which are of outer are accessible to inner. Outer variables are accessible throughout that outer, no doubt, because they are local to that outer. But they are also accessible to inner if inner has not defined its own with the same name. Correct? Like here, if suppose I have written y equal to 20. Getting? So now can g access y of outer? No, because it has created its own. Its local variable is there, no? Y with the value 20. As there is a local variable y with the value 20, now it cannot access this y, because its local y has hided that outer y. But g can access this x and z, because inside g there is no variable defined with the name y and z. Okay, so those are called as enclosing scope. Okay, so enclosing scope means variables of outer accessible to inner. Outer is also called as enclosing function, no? Yes or no? And who is called as enclosed? The inner one. Correct? Inner one is called as enclosed because it is getting enclosed. And who is enclosing it? Outer. So outer is the enclosing one. So enclosing scope means what? Variables of outer accessible to inner. But when they are accessible to inner, if inner has not created its own, okay, so such scope is called as a enclosing scope. And the variables of outer which are accessible to inner, they are called as non-locals. Always remember, what are non-locals? Non-locals are locals of outer but accessible to inner. Those variables which are accessible to inner but they are local of outer. X, Y, Z, tell me, are they local of F? Yes. So they are local, but are they accessible to G, Z and X?
Yes.
Yes. So when they are accessible to inner, then they become non-local. Non-local means, just remember, which is neither global nor local.
Or local.
Clear? Means it is neither local because it's not its own, and it is not global also. It is neither global and not of its own also, that is local. But still it is able to access those variables. Okay, that inner function is able to access that variable, but that variable which it is accessing is not its own also, and it is not the global one also. Correct? You understanding?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So
yes,
those
sir.
Variables are called as non-local. Means it is neither public property nor owned. So it is obviously of your parent that way. Means the thing which are of public, which is accessible to everyone. So that is global. If you have earned it, it is local. And what you get from your parent, parents are, we say, no, we are always under the shelter of our parent. Getting? So whatever of your parent, we are accessing it. Clear? So they become non-local. So always remember, non-local. Is it local for someone?
Yes.
It has to be local for someone. So it is local for outer. Clear? It is local for outer. right? It is local for outer, but accessible to whom? Inner. So inner is able to access it, but it is actually a variable of its outer function. So they become non-local. And why we have to call their scope as enclosing scope? Because it is from the enclosed function. The access of this x and z here is from where? From the enclosing function. Clear? So that's the reason it is called as enclosing scope. Okay. I'll give you some illustrations. We'll come to that. So Python allows us to define function inside function. So this concept, enclosing scope, is applicable for this thing only. Defining one inner function inside outer function. Okay, one function inside another function you can define. But remember that inner function you cannot call it directly outside outer anywhere. Outside outer, you cannot directly call that inner. Inner can be called only inside outer. Inner can be called only inside outer, but not outside outer. You are understanding? Not outside outer. It can be called only inside inner, anywhere. Then, variable which is defined in outer function, but accessible to the inner function, are called non-local variable. Okay? So, is every non-local a local to someone?
Yes.
So every non-local is local to someone. So it is local to its outer function. That is, it is local to enclosing function. But it is accessible to enclosed function. But why it is accessible to enclosed? Or why it is accessible to inner? Because inner has not defined a variable of its own with the same name. Clear? Okay. See here. Its scope is in the function in which it is defined. See this one, this outer variable. Okay, its scope is this x, y, z. Its scope is throughout its own function and as well as the inner function also. Okay, see this is one outer, maybe this is one inner, still inner. Okay, now can you tell me if there is x and y here, so can x and y be accessed throughout its own function?
Yes.
As well as the inner also, if inner yes. have not created of its own. Getting?
Yes.
Suppose, now here it is y and z. Okay? Y and z is there. And here there is own k. So tell me, is this second inner function able to access x of outer?
Yes.
Yeah. It can access x of 1, 2, 3. So can this 2 access x of 1? Yes, but cannot access y because it has defined its own. Okay? Now can 3 access z of 2? And x of 1 and y
yes.
of 2.
Yes.
Can
yes.
it access 2's z? Okay. Means this one. Can it access 2's y?
Yes.
Yes. And can it access 1's
yes.
x also?
Yes.
Yes.
Clear? The rules are clear to you now. Okay. Huh. But this 3 cannot access which y? One's y. Because 2 has defined its own. Isn't it? No? Clear? Like a parent and then they are enclosed in their parent. Clear? So grandparent, parent and you. This way. So this y is now hided by this 2. Because y has been created here. So now 3 can access only 2's y, not 1's y. But 3 can access this x and 3 can access this 2z also. Okay? तो द रूल्स आर क्लियर. तो इट्स स्कोप इज इन फंक्शन इन विच इट इज डिफाइंड एंड इन ऑल इन अ फंक्शंस विच हैव नॉट डिफाइंड वेरिएबल विद द सेम नेम. तो आउट ऑफ फंक्शन हैज क्रिएटेड वन वेरिएबल, तो नाउ दैट वेरिएबल इज एक्सेबल थ्रू आउट इट्स ओन फंक्शन एज वेल एज द इनर फंक्शन ऑल्सो दोज हु हैव नॉट डिफाइंड अ वेरिएबल विद द सेम नेम. तो सच स्कोप इज कॉल्ड एज एनक्लोजिंग स्कोप. ओके, नाउ जस्ट चेक वन एग्जाम्पल. सी हियर, आई हैव डिफाइंड वन फंक्शन पुणे विच इज अ आउटर फंक्शन. इट इज हैविंग इट्स ओन लोकल वेरिएबल ए विच इज 10. ए इज लोकल ऑफ आउटर, बट इफ इट इज एक्सेबल टू इनर देन इट बिकम्स अ नॉन लोकल टू इनर. ठीक है, नाउ अकोर्ड इज अ इनर फंक्शन, बट दिस विल गेट एग्जीक्यूटेड ओनली वेन यू कॉल. इट इज जस्ट अ डेफिनेशन, जस्ट रिमेंबर दिस इज जस्ट अ डेफिनेशन. दिस थ्री लाइन्स विल एग्जीक्यूट ओनली वेन यू कॉल. अनलेस एंड अंटिल यू कॉल दिस थ्री लाइन्स वॉन्ट रन. तो यू हैव कॉल्ड अकोर्डी, करेक्ट. वेन अकोर्डी इज कॉल्ड इन साइड दैट इट हैज डिफाइंड इट्स ओन बी, बट इट इज एक्सिंग ए ऑफ द आउटर. ठीक है, एंड देन वेन यू प्रिंट ए इट इज स्टिल इट्स ओन ए. नाउ वेन आई कॉल पुणे, एग्जीक्यूशन विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम ए इक्वल टू 10. Whenever I'll call Pune, will it first come to A equal to 10? Yes.
Yes.
Means it will create its own A. Then will it come to call to Akurdi? This is just a definition. This first line done. Then will it come to Akurdi call?
Yes.
Goes to Akurdi. Create its own B with value 20. Print A, print B. But when you're printing A, it doesn't get a local A. So will it go and access the non-local A?
Yes.
Yes.
Outer A, that is 10. And will it print its own local B? 20. So 10 and 20, done. Function over, come back. Now when you are printing A, it will print its own local A. That is 10. Okay? So the printing will be 10, 20 and again 10. Right? I hope it is clear. Okay? So now in this case, can you tell me who is non-local to Akurdi?
A.
A. A is non-local to Akurdi. Why? Because it is a local of outer. It is local to outer, but it is accessible to inner. Again, remember, non-locals means they are already local to someone. Every non-local has to be a local. For whom? To the outer. But it is accessible to इनर. ठीक है, तो इट इज एक्सेसिबल टू इनर बट इट इज लोकल ऑफ आउटर. सी इन दिस कोड बी हैज लोकल स्कोप. व्हाई वी शुड कॉल बी एज लोकल? बिकॉज इट इज डिफाइंड विद इन दैट फंक्शन बॉडी. क्लियर, तो बी इज लोकल टू अकुरुडी एंड ए वी आर एबल टू एक्सेस, बट इट इज एक्चुअली अ लोकल ऑफ हु? Of its outer. So variable which are local, variables which are local of outer but accessible to inner, they become non-local. See, A has non-local scope in Akurdi. So output, you got it. So in general we can announce that those variables which are neither global nor local are called as non-local. With those which are not global also, see here, this A, we are accessing here A, but is this A defined in its own body? No, means it is not even local. And is it global? Is it defined somewhere outside the function? No, means this A is neither local nor global. So obviously it will be called as a non-local. Okay, and the scope is where? Is the scope in its own body? Is the scope throughout the script? Or is the scope only in the outer function? And the outer function is always called as enclosing function. And the inner function is always called as enclosed function. correct? So terminologies you should remember. Okay, so I hope it is clear that basic things are clear to you. And now coming to built-in scope. Okay. Now, what is built-in scope? I'll come to that. Built-in scope is considered as a super global scope. The mechanism is like that. See, the function own variable, this will be called as local. It is able to access the variables of outer, okay, because it has not defined its own. So it is able to access the outer function. So that is called as enclosing scope. Okay. And the variables which are created within that script throughout that script which are accessible, they are global. Okay. And those variables which are accessible within the scripts, means this script and this script, both can access it. Getting? So not only variables, even functions also get loaded here. The best example is all your built-in functions. All the built-in functions like print, input, type, ID, many are there. Clear? They all are not present in any module. Right? They get loaded in some shared memory and all the scripts are able to access it. Means your b.py also is able to access it and a.py. So this goes in super global scope or also called as a built-in scope. Okay? So built-in scope means that scope or the scope in which the variables are created and they are accessible to all the scripts. Means this script and this script both can access it. When it is accessible throughout the script, global, outer but accessible to inner, enclosing, and its own local. So the concept which today she was asking, that also comes here only in the same category. Like for example, one script variable, other two, three scripts are accessing it. Means this script variable. Best example is math module. Like if you import math module, whenever you import math module, the math module will come in this super global scope. And then everyone is able to use that math module. Getting? Now in math module, there are many constant variables like pi, math.py, math.e, Euler value, Euler constant, I hope you know it. See, when you import math and then math dot, when you do dot, it gives you a list. See, there is a pi constant and when you print it, it will show you that value of pi. So this math.py value will go in this super global scope and every script is able to access it, those who import it. Getting? So when those who import it, means it's not coming in their namespace, it is kept in some super global space and everyone is accessing from that super global scope. Getting? So that is called as a built-in scope. So built-in scope, always remember, that shared memory where the variables are kept and all the scripts can access the variables from that shared memory. Getting? So something like public property, as I said, which is not belonging to any individual. That property, one single owner is not there of that. Everyone can access it. Public property. Clear? Then those which are accessible to your family only. So they become global. Clear? And then between parent and child, accessible. So parent value accessible to child, so it is enclosing. and child of child access its own, so it is local. Okay, so built-in scope, I hope you got it. So you can call it as a super global scope also. So built-in scope is a special Python scope that is created or loaded when you run a script or when you start your Python interactive environment. So whenever the interactive environment starts, it creates one shared memory, and in that shared memory only, okay, all these functions get loaded, and every script can access that functions. Okay, not only functions, variables are also there. The best example which I gave, like math.py. Okay, so when you import, it's getting loaded in some shared memory. And now my script, someone else's script, means if I create two, three more scripts, all are going to access that py from that shared memory only, which is a super global. So can also be called as a super global scope because it is accessible to all the scripts. Getting? The best example is all these functions like print and ID, they all get loaded in that shared space. When your interactive environment starts, that time only that super global space is created where these all functions are getting loaded, and every script is accessing these functions. Getting? So pictorially, if I show you, so the nearest scope is local. So what you'll remember, the variables which are created within that function body, local. Variables created in the outer function but accessible to inner, enclosing. Variables created in the script, okay? Variables created in the script and accessible throughout the script to everyone, global. And those which are created in some shared memory and all scripts can use it, so that is built in. So that is called as leg B rule. This is very common interview question, related to leg B. Okay, so till here, if it is clear, give me confirmation. Then we have to discuss two keywords. Okay, one is called as a local key, global keyword, and one is non-local. Okay, so till here, if it is clear, please tell me.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir, where we will get a list of all these built-in functions?
You can do manual, may help is there.
Okay.
Or in that IDLE also, there is an help. From there also you can get. Or the best option is go to Python official website. python.org, na? They have given their documentation. So in that documentation, alphabetically everything is given. All functions, their syntaxes with an example. Normally I go there only. Many times I explore that python.org, because on python.org, a proper documentation they have given, their official website.
Okay, sir, thank you.
Like those who have a habit of Microsoft products, so they use that MSDN, no? Like all these Microsoft products, whenever you work on VB or so, Microsoft has given their own helps, no? Like Sun also, like if you're doing work on Java, the Sun document has been provided. So Python people also have given their document, very properly given document. Now we are moving to the discussion global keyword. This is a new keyword in Python. Till now, whatever keywords we have learned in this, one more keyword in your knowledge now. Okay. So for what this global keyword is, I'll tell you. Now already we know that if you are creating a variable with the same name as the global within the function, then it is not going to modify the global. It will create its own as a local variable. Isn't it? See here, define f, and within that function, I'm creating a variable with the same name as that of a global. as that of a global. Means I'm creating a variable with the same name as that of a global within the function. So it is not going to modify the global. Rather, it will create its own local variable. Right? See, if I print A, it's going to print that local A. Now, before calling that function, I'm going to print A. Is it going to print that global A? Because you're printing it outside function. So it is going to print this globally. Print A. Okay, so it will print 10. Now I'm calling that function. When I call the function, it comes to function definition. But within that function definition, you're creating a variable A with the same name as the global. So it is not going to modify the global. It will create its own and print its own local variable. So it will print 20. But if I try to print that global A again, so will it be 20 or still 10 only?
10.
Still 10. It has not changed it to 20 because this A is not the global one. It has created its local, which we have been discussing in the past four topics. Remember, for past four types. So in that we have now got to know that whenever you create a variable with the same name as that of global, it is not going to modify the global, rather it will create a local one. See, your A is still 10. But suppose sometimes you don't want a local variable to get created. Rather, it should modify the global only. Instead of creating a local variable of its own, it should make changes to the global only. Okay, so for that we have to use a documenting statement called global. Clear? A documenting command is there, or a keyword. Okay, see here, I'll tell you. A equal to 10, I'm defining F. Within that I'm writing global A. If there are many globals, you can list out A, B, C, whatever. So as there is one, I'm writing one. Global A. This is a documentation statement, or it is a reporting line to the interpreter. Means you are informing to the interpreter that within this function body, means throughout this function body, wherever you will see A, please consider it as global A. Meaning, don't create a variable of your own. Means don't create a local variable, rather consider that A as a global A only. You understanding? Clear? See, global A. If you're printing A, still it will print the global A. You're modifying A. Okay? Again you're printing A. So we feel as if A equal to 20 means it will create its own, because till now we have learned that thing only that within the function whenever a variable is created, it's a local. If this line is not there, then it is going to create a local, and moreover it's going to give an error for this line, unbound local variable. But as I have reported this, you have already informed to the interpreter that please use which A throughout the body. Don't consider or don't create a variable of your own. Okay? Please consider it as global only. Right? I hope you're understanding. See ya. Print A. Before that, F is called. I have not called F. So print A. Will it print this global A that is 10? Right, guys? Then I'm calling F. When I call F, it goes here. This is already a documenting line informing please use A as a global A. So will it print A as global A? That is 10. Will it make global A only 20? And now when you're printing A, 20, so 10 and 20 it will print, no doubt. But now if I print A, is your A changed to 20 or is it still 10?
20.
It is changed to 20 because of this statement. This statement, clear, informing that in the whole code, wherever A come, it has to be globally. So though you are assigning also, it will not create a new A of its own. It will store that 20 in the global one only. See ya. Is it printing A as 20 now? This proves that this function has assigned 20 to A, but which A it has assigned? The global. The global one has become from 10 to 20. And that's the reason after function call, when you print A, it prints 20. Is it clear? So I hope the concept of global keyword is clear. Global keyword is just to document, or it is just to report to the interpreter that within the function body, wherever a variable with that name occurs, please don't create a variable of your own with that name. Consider it as a global. Okay? Please don't create a variable of your own with the same name. Rather, consider it as the global. Clear? I hope you understand. See that. Note that if you assign value to a variable inside a function, which I have been telling you from the past, that whenever you assign any value to a variable is created. Isn't it? That is the principle of Python. In Python, how do we say the variable is created? When you assign. When you assign, a variable is defined. Okay? But if you are assigning a value to a variable within the function, then it creates a local variable. Right? So note that if you assign a value to a variable inside a function, which is having same name as a global variable, then does it modify the global one or does it create its own? Question is, okay, see, this is your global variable and this is a function inside which also there is a definition of A. Definition means you are assigning a value to a variable with the same name as the global variable. So what it does it store 20 in this global A or does it create a local variable with the same name? It creates a local variable of its own. Yes or no, guys?
If we are going to use global word, then it will be a global variable.
That is criteria. By default, I'm talking. By default, unless we use the global keyword. Clear? So having same name as a global variable, then local variable is created. Instead of modifying the global variable. Okay, see, A equal to 10, I've defined Akurdi, I'm storing 20 in A, I'm printing it. Okay, now Akurdi called. So when Akurdi is called, it goes there. Does it store 20 in this global A or its local A? Local. Print that local.
Yes, sir.
And now when I try to print this A, it is still 10. Because it has not stored this 20 in the global one. It has created its own. Getting? So, if you want to make changes to global variable instead of local. Okay, you want to make the changes to a variable, but it should not create its own. It should take the outer, the global one only. Then use global keyword. Clear? See you. Now, in this is global. We have defined Akurdi. We have done the documenting line, reporting line. Global A. So as this global A is a reporting interpreter, that in the whole body, wherever you'll see A, please consider global. So though you are assigning also, it is not going to assign to a local, it will assign to global. So global 10 is changed to 20. You're printing A, which will print 20. See here, Akurdi called, goes there. This statement informs, consider it as global. 20 stored in A. So तो विल इट स्टोर इन दिस ग्लोबल ए 20? यस, देन यू आर प्रिंटिंग ए, करेक्ट, विच इज 20. एंड आफ्टर फंक्शन कॉल इज ओवर, इफ यू ट्राई टू प्रिंट ए, विल इट बी 10 ओनली और इज इट मॉडिफाइड टू 20 नाउ?
20.
ठीक है, दैट्स वॉट, दैट्स द डिफरेंस, द डिफरेंस बिटवीन दिस कोड एंड दिस कोड. आई होप यू आर एबल टू डिफरेंशिएट, राइट ना?
Sir, one thing, for example, like in the same example, this define according, after define according, if we are giving a equal to 20 and after that this global a.
I guess this global line has to be a beginning line in the
function. Okay.
That reporting statement should be the first statement only.
Okay.
We'll see this. You want to say like I'm creating a equal to 20 and then globally like this, no?
Yes, sir.
Clear? And then maybe you are creating a equal to 30 or then you are printing. It's a syntax error. That's what I said.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
So that's what I said, ki that global line has to be a first documenting line. It's a reporting line. So you have to announce it at the beginning of the function only. Where the function start, na? The beginning only you have to announce that please consider this as global. Clear? Clear. At least with this curiosity questions, my knowledge base also increase. Because now after in the next batch, if someone asks, I am already having the answer. Getting, no? Coming to the next one, that is non-local. Non-local keyword was not there in Python 2. It has been introduced in Python 3 only. Python 2 doesn't support only. Python 3 has introduced this keyword. Global was there in Python 2 also. Analogy is there. The purpose is similar. Like when you want to modify the globals inside the function. The purpose is same. When you want to modify the non-locals. When you want to modify the non-local inside the local scope. Then we use this non-local keyword. Getting? See ya. When I define one outer function, define foo, it is having its own variable x equal to 20. And then define bar, in which again I am creating x equal to 50. X equal to 30, x equal to 50. Print x. So now you know that when an inner function creates a variable with the same name as the variables of outer. When the inner function is creating a variable with the same name as the variable name of outer, then it is not going to modify the outer variable. Rather, it will create a local one. Is this x equal to 50? Is it going to modify the outer x from 30 to 50, or will it create its local x with value 50? What say, guys? According to the knowledge till now, whatever knowledge we have gained from the past, you know it, x equal to 50. So is it going to store 50 in this outer x, or will it create its local x?
Local x.
That is the rule. That's the rule, no? Within the function body, whenever you assign anything to a local variable is created. Clear? See here. Now, in foo, I'm printing x value. I'm calling bar. And then again, I'm printing x value. ठीक है. नाउ आई एम गिविंग कॉल टू फू, टेल मी व्हेन आई गिव कॉल टू फू इट विल कम हियर, विल इट क्रिएट इट्स लोकल एक्स, एक्स इक्वल टू 30, यस. देन विल इट कम हियर, दिस इज जस्ट द डेफिनेशन, बार इज जस्ट डिफाइंड. अनलेस एंड अंटिल यू कॉल दिस टू लाइंस वोंट गेट एग्जीक्यूटेड, रिमेंबर, क्लियर. तो फू इज कॉल्ड, कम हियर, डिफाइन लोकल एक्स 30, प्रिंट एक्स, विल इट प्रिंट इट्स लोकल एक्स, इट्स ओन एक्स,
यस,
तो इट विल प्रिंट 30, करेक्ट, फर्स्ट 30. नाउ बार इज कॉल्ड, व्हेन बार इज कॉल्ड विल इट क्रिएट अगेन इट्स लोकल एक्स,
यस
50, इट विल प्रिंट दैट 50. नाउ बार ओवर एंड इट कम बैक अगेन टू फू, बार इज ओवर एंड इट कम्स बैक टू फू, एंड व्हेन वी प्रिंट एक्स विल इट प्रिंट एक्स ऑफ फू which is still 30 only.
Yes, yes, 30.
Is that 30 become 50? No, it is still 30 only. See, 30, 50, 30. Getting? So now in this situation, suppose within the inner function, you want the variable which are getting created or accessed, they should be considered of the outer instead of creating a local one. The same explanation which I gave for global and local, now it is non-local and local. Get it? So suppose if you want to make modification to which variable? Inside the local function, you want the non-local should get accessed or modified. Then use non-local keyword. Clear? See, you know, in this whole body, here only one keyword documenting keyword I am writing, non-local. This is also a reporting line, nx. Now what I am announcing inside that inner function? I am announcing that within this whole body, wherever x will come, please consider it as a outer function variable. Don't create your own. This line is informing to the interpreter, correct? What? Please use which x? A non-local x. Non-local x meaning local of outer, correct? So we are telling that inside this whole body, wherever x will come, okay, meaning accessed or modified, please modify or access the which one? The outer one. Don't create your own. Correct? Okay. Now this function is defined. Now I am calling foo. See here the output. When foo is called, will it go to foo? Will it create its local x 30? This x equal to 30, which will be local of foo?
Yes.
Print 30. Will it print 30 first? Okay. Then will it go to bar? But inside bar, as this documenting line is done, will it copy 50 in its local x or the outer x?
Outer local.
Outer. Clear? Global word we cannot use. We can use word non-local. Okay. So, will it store this 50 in the outer function x? Yes. It prints that 50. Bar over, come back to foo. And when x is printed, will it print local x of foo? Yes. But is it 30 or is it being changed to 50?
50.
It is changed to 50. Get it? Check the difference. 30, 50, 50. So only because of this one documenting line, it has stored 50 in which x? Its own x or the outer x? Outer. I'm not talking about global. Outer and global is different. Huh? Which x it is accessing? X equal to 50. So is it creating x of its own or is it accessing x of the outer? And that outer x it is changing to 50. Is it clear or no? Just give me some confirmation.
Clear, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Today many are absent.
Yes, sir.
Okay, coming back. Okay, so let's see how the function is. Pune. Pune has defined its local A. A equal to 1 is local to Pune. Then Akurdi has assigned 2 to A. But will it assign 2 to which A? The outer Pune's A or of its own only?
Own.
And is B also going to be local? Yes.
Yes.
B to anyway is local only. But as A name was conflicting with the outer A, so you know that within the function body, whenever you create a variable with the same name as the outer, it doesn't modify the outer, it creates its own. Okay? So local A, local B. Okay? And then you're calling Akurdi and then you're printing A. Okay? See ya. Now when I call Pune, first will it come here and create its local variable A equal to 1. Okay? Then it will come to call to Akurdi. Akurdi created its two local variable, printed 2 and 2. 2, 2. Now Akurdi complete. Will it come to print A? Will it print its local A only? That is 1. Is it right? Means in short, when I wrote A equal to 2, has it modified the outer A from 1 to 2 or has it created A of its own?
Own.
Yes. Clear? See here. A equal to 2 inside Akurdi doesn't change A of Pune. This A equal to 2 which I'm doing, it's not modifying Pune's A. It is modifying its, it is creating its own. That is by the rule. Okay. Like the global keyword, now if you want to make change to the non-local, means inside inner function, you want the outer function variables to get modified. Inside inner, you want the outer function variables should get modified. Getting? Then, which keyword you'll use? Non-local. Because unless you use that keyword, it will keep creating its own. Though the name is same, but still it will create its own. See ya. The same code, only one line I have introduced inside Akurdi, non-local A. Okay? Now when I call Pune, again tell me, when I call Pune, it comes here, create its local A, then give call to Akurdi, come here. Okay, it creates local A of Pune, then Akurdi is called, but this keyword is informing that consider A not as local, consider it as outer. So when it copies 2 in A, does it copy 2 in its own A or the outer A? Outer A. This one becomes 2 and B is local anyway. These two values are printed, 2 and 2. Akurdi complete, come back to Pune. And when Pune is printing its own A, this A is already changed to 2 because of Akurdi. Clear? And 2. Suppose in this whole code, if I don't give call to Akurdi, so is that print A 2 or it will remain 1 only? In the same code, if I don't give call to bar, okay? So is that x going to change to 50 or will it remain 30-30 only?
Same 30.
Clear? Why? Because bar is just defined. You didn't called only. You understanding or no? Bar is just defined inside foo. So these three lines will get executed only when it is called. So you didn't called anywhere bar inside foo. Inside foo, have you called bar anywhere? No. So as you didn't call, this lines didn't get executed and therefore it didn't change this outer x 30 to 50. Getting? So that concept you should know.
Sir, this inner function is a part of outer function still to call explicitly, right?
Yes, because it is just a definition. def keyword just defines the function. For every user defined function, there are two parts. One is defining and one is defining the function and calling the function.
Calling the function.
Unless and until you call, the code within it won't get executed. No? I gave an example. No? You have purchased a very costly crores car, but it is just kept in a parking and you never start it and bring on the road and you don't utilize it. So what's the use? Getting? Same way. You're just defining. Def keyword just tells what logic or what algorithm or what task the function is going to do. You're telling to the interpreter, this is the task which this function is going to do. But unless and until you call it, that code won't run.
Yeah.
Right? And calling means requesting. Requesting to get executed. Okay? So though it is defined inside outer, but then also it's a definition. You call, then only it will run. Okay.
Excuse me, sir. So basically the difference between global and non-local is global will make difference, we can modify the super global values, and with non-local we modify the level upper values. How?
No, throughout the script is, means if you are creating a file, suppose you have created a file with any name. Okay. Now inside this, whatever variables I create, these are globals, correct? Now I'm defining foo. Here I am having some variable. This is local to foo. And def bar. And here I am writing something. Correct? And then bar I am going to call it. Okay? So see, this bar variable, A is a variable of its own. So this is local. Variable of outer but accessible to inner, this becomes non-local, and those which are outside the function but accessible throughout the script, these are global, and those which are accessible within the scripts, like this script and another script, they all can share it, that is super global. Got it on?
Okay, sir. Yes, sir.
So this whole script, this dot py test2.py, in this you created this A, so this A is accessible throughout the script, so this is global. Outer but accessible to inner, this is non-local. Its own inner, that is local, and between one script and another script, anything which can be shared, that is super global. Right? Hope it is clear. Okay, so scopes and all, these are very important concepts. Inner scope, inner functions and all. Now we are moving to another very, very important topic again, that is lambda function. Okay, but again 5 minutes, within 5 minutes. Okay, at least definition I'll tell you. What is a lambda function? The lambda function, this is again derived from lambda calculus. It comes from mathematics origin. Okay. To what? There is concept called Church hypothesis and all. I won't go into more of mathematical background. Now just remember, from programming perspective, C, C++ and all, they don't have such lambda function concept. Now in Java 8 and onwards, they have introduced in Java as well, this concept has been bought. Okay. PHP was already having, but actually PHP was already having means PHP is a later language. They have copied from Python only over there. So lambda functions means functions without name. They are also called as anonymous functions. Okay. It's called as an anonymous function. There is a function without a name. Okay, and every lambda function performs only a single line task, not even return. It doesn't do return also. It is just for evaluating a single line expression. Okay, but they can take parameters. Parameters can be passed to it. Okay, it will return you the answer. Right, but it performs only a single line task. Now, how to define it, that I'll tell you. But before that, always remember, every function is an object. According to Python, each function is an object. This foo is also an object, remember. And it's an object of class function. If you check it, type foo, you'll come to know. It is an object of class function. See here, class function. Okay, so that lambda function also, whichever you'll create, you'll get a function object only. Okay, and how to create a lambda function, that I'll tell you. Lambda keyword is there. What are their benefits and all, I'll tell you. You can pass parameters to it and it just performs some single line task, single line expression. Like it is giving you cube of x. ठीक है तो नाउ ओनली द एनोनिमस फंक्शन इज डिफाइंड ओके दिस इज एन एनोनिमस फंक्शन इट हैज डिफाइंड वन फंक्शन विदाउट अ नेम एंड इट इज टेकिंग वन पैरामीटर एक्स एंड इट इज गोइंग टू रिटर्न एक्स क्यूब नाउ इन एफ द आंसर ऑफ एक्स क्यूब हैज नॉट कम दैट एनोनिमस फंक्शन हैज कम इन एफ मीनिंग that f is now a object of class function. You can check it. See, print type of f. See, it's an object of class function. And now use that f to execute this code. So you can do it. F of 3 if I write, it will return you 3 cube. See, f of 5, it will return 5 cube. You're getting clear? Okay, now lambda functions can take more than one arguments as well. Like g equal to lambda. I'm passing x comma y. And it is returning x raised to y, suppose. Okay? Again, g is not containing the answer of x raised to y. G is containing that whole lambda function. This whole lambda function reference. Means here a lambda function is created, which is again an object only, which is coming in G. And if you check, G is also again an object of class function. Getting? And through G, if I write 5 comma 3, or I'm writing 2 comma 10, it will return 2 raised to 10. Means it's going to execute this code. Okay? Now, you may ask what are its applications. So sure, we are going to see that. And applications also we are going to discuss with examples. Okay. So the main topic is that. Okay. What are the applications of this lambda function? And then the syntax. Okay. So in the next lecture, in the next class, we'll discuss about the syntax of lambda function. What are lambda functions? Applications of lambda functions.